curious to see how an old free-to-play player is doing at this state in Rising Kingdoms. Stick around, find out. I've started the game around Thanksgiving in November 2018 out of boredom, and I've logged in every day since. My journey started in 1142, a former Imperian kingdom which was a home for the monsters known as Jay and Ticklefist. After a couple of months of playing, I became an R4, an alliance best known as Blazing Phoenix. Shortly after, I became the R5, and I've been at it for nearly 3 years. My team and I had been through it all, through six alliances, Imperian Kingdom, to a one alliance kingdom, from internal drama and civil wars, to restructuring the kingdom to a proper size, which gave us 4 KVK wins in a row. Leadership fatigue kicked in, and our group decided to migrate in order to relieve ourselves of leadership duties, and so we moved to 1965 in the summer of 2022. After 2 KVKs in the kingdom became like our former one, and right now we're in 2755, freshly migrated. I've always been a team player, and I believe my marches and stats reflect that. As a free-to-play, your options are quite limited, and that is both a good and a bad thing. The bad thing is you cannot rally your garrison, but the good thing is that the only thing you need to do is specialize in the open field to help your kingdom. I like to define myself as a skill damage player, not specializing in a specific troop type, but in marches that can nuke the target as fast as possible, while providing buffs and debuffs to everyone around me. I know eyebrows will be raised by my seemingly low kill points, and I understand, but take in mind I was nearly zeroed in the winter of 2020. I passed out on the front line late in the night, and I lost 2.7 million troops out of the 3.3 million that I had, and that took me over a year to recover from. I've spent a good amount of time with less than 1.5 million troops, but I've still contributed in reaching my deaths, but my kills suffer because of it. The lineup that you will see later in the video is relatively new. I only used it last KVK, and it gave me nearly double the kills I got before, so I'm not worried about the kill points, especially now since I've upgraded even further by maxing Nevsky today and making gear and armament upgrades. The marches I used before were Guan and 5511 Leo, Alex with YSG, Saladin William, both 5551, and Trajan Etelflaed. Another reason why my kill points are suffering is because of my resource management. I'm a lazy farmer and I know it. I've never been able to consistently farm for myself, and I've usually been helped by friends, looting cities, supplying passports, and receiving fines. I have two farms that I only started using a year ago, but I bet I don't have a billion gathered between them combined. So, my plans in the future is I will be saving my heads. I will not be investing in the ranged commanders simply because I don't see myself playing it. And it's a debatable question if it is viable as a free-to-play, maybe in less active kingdoms, but for me, I will abstain from it for now. I might go for five marches, but once again, the biggest problem for me are the resources, which is why I re definitely recommend using a mix of T5 and T4 because it's way cheaper and it's way more sustainable for 95% of the people playing. If you want a field with full T5s, I suggest you leave it to the big whales. And yeah. Also, what you can expect are more videos from me about Rise of Kingdoms. mostly about leveraging value from events, which events to skip, and so on. I want to share my personal experiences, and most importantly, I want to showcase a different mindset with the free-to-play, and maybe even a low spender that you can maybe not thrive, I will not use the word, but you can definitely still play the game if you made the right decisions. And nowadays it's very easy to make bad decisions, lots of events and things to spend gems on, and sometimes even for myself it's hard to stay focused. Sometimes I get demotivated as well if I get a really bad report. But with the upcoming updates, it seems more viable, and the fact that the PC version has helped me personally immense with the lag, I think there is more potential to be had from the free-to-play community. I would also like to present a free-to-play mindset that doesn't complain. I know, you know, free-to-play get a bad reputation for just constantly complaining, and I understand, but you gotta accept the truth that the game does not cater to the free-to-play, and once you do that, your gameplay will be far more enjoyable.